morning, dear students. Welcome to biology class. In this class, we have to discuss about the Bellac-Operon concept. In our previous classes, we have studied about the translation process. See, actually, the translation, it is nothing but the process of polymerization of, means the process of polymerization of amino acids to form a polypeptide. So, in this class, we have to learn about the Bellac-Operon concept. Listen, this is a very important for your examination. See here, actually we already know about the operator. It is nothing but the operon. See the one of the structural molecule. Means it is one of the polycystronic structural molecule and which is regulated by the, some of the common promoters as well as some of the proteins. Means the operon, it is nothing but the, it is a polycystronic structural molecule and which is regulated by common promoter and regulatory genes. See here, the first time the Bellac-Operon concept proposed by, means it was first time proposed by, means it was first time discovered by two scientists. Those are the Jaffo and Mona. Jacob and Monod. See, the Franco is Jacob and Jacques Monod proposed the concept Bellac-Operon. See, the operator or the operon, which is the polycystronic structural molecule and which is regulated by a common promoters and regulatory genes. See, actually what happened? The bacteria almost, means generally prepare the glucose. Means the glucose is the carbon source, means which is helps to obtain the energy. See, actually the bacteria, the some of the microorganisms, see here the bacteria generally prepare a glucose and which is the one of the carbon source to obtain energy. But in this condition, what happened here? The lactose also one of the disaccharide. Means the lactose, it is a combination between the glucose plus galactose. Means the glucose and galactose which is combined to form lactose. So here in this condition, the lactose is the only source for the, means it is also one of the carbon source in that of the environment. So here the bacteria which is synthesized, the one of the enzyme which is the beta galactosidase, and this enzyme, it helps to break down the lactose into glucose and galactose. See what happened here. See, the actually the lactose, one of the disaccharide, see, is one of the sugar molecule. See, it is breaks down into glucose plus galactose. See, actually the bacteria generally prefer glucose as a carbon source because of to obtain the energy. And also the lactose is also one of the carbon source in the environment. So the bacteria synthesizes the one of the enzyme, that is the beta galactosidase. And the beta galactosidase, the enzyme which is helps to break down the lactose into glucose and galactose. And also the beta galactosidase, the enzyme which is along with the two more enzymes. Those are the permease and transacetylase. See here, the two more enzymes, those are the permease and transacetylase. See, actually bacteria synthesizes the beta galactosidase. Those are the enzymes here. See, the beta galactosidase and another one, permease and the transacetylase. Actually the bacteria synthesizes the enzyme beta galactosidase. So here the beta galactosidase, synthesizer. Actually, bacteria synthesizes the enzyme beta galactoside along with the permease and transacetyl acetate, which is also required for the utilization of the lactose in the lab operon concept. So here, the totally in this concept, it depends on the one of the inducer. So here, I draw two diagrams. See, one is in absence of inducer and the second one is in presence of inducer. So here the main the concept is based on the presence and absence of inducer. So here the inducer, it is nothing but the means here the lactose, it acts as an inducer because of the lactose, which is the means it is one of the substrate for the enzyme. It regulates the switching on and off of the operon. So the term as inducer. So here the lactose acts as an inducer, means because of the whole concept depends on the inducer. So in the absence as well as in the present. So here the lactose is the substrate for the means for the enzyme beta galactoside, and which is regulate the switching on and switching off of the mechanism of the lac operon and the concept which is the inducer. So here the first, which is the in absence of inducer. So here in the lac operon concept, which is depends on the absence and presence of the inducer, and already we know that the inducer, it is one of the means the lactose, which is regulate the switching on and switching off of the mechanism, and the third as inducer. So here the absence of the inducer means, see here the P, I and the O. See here the whole the process, the lac operon, which is consists of three structural genes. Those are the means the promoter, and here the I represents, that is the inhibitory gene, and here the operator, and three structural genes, that the Z, Y and A. See here the first, it consists of three structural genes. Those are the Z, Y, A. See here the Z, which is codes for the beta galactoside, and Y codes for a permease, and A codes for transacetylase. But here the I, it is not represents the inducer. It represents the one of the gene. This is the inhibitory gene. See, the I represents inhibitory gene. See, the P is nothing but the promoter, and O, it is nothing but the repressor. See, and the P is the promoter, R, it is nothing but the inducer. It is represented as inhibitory gene. And here the Z, Y, A, these all are the structural genes in this of the concept, and Z, which is codes for the beta galactosidase enzyme. And the Y, it is also one of the structural gene, and the Y represents, means Y codes for the enzyme permease, and A, which is also codes for the transacetylase enzyme. But here the important of the permease means, which is helps to increase the means the permeability, means it helps to increase the permeability of the cell to the lactose. See here the permease, which is coded by the Y, so one of the structural gene, and it helps to increase the permeability of the cell to the lactose. See here the lac, it is nothing but the lactose. See, it is a combination between the glucose and galactose, and it is also one of the carbon source in the environment. So this is about the introduction of the lac operon. See, actually the operon, it is one of the polycystronic structural gene regulated by common promoter and regulatory genes. And here the inducer, it is here the lactose, which is act as the inducer, binds to the operator region. See, actually the processing which is involved the repressor mRNA. This is the mRNA. See, this is the inhibitory gene. So here the repressor mRNA means the repressor. This is the repressor. It binds into the operator. So it means why the repressor binds to the operator region and prevent RNA polymerase means from the transplant in the opener. So here there is no any formation of the structural gene. Because of the reason, here the repressor only binds to the operator region. It means it prevents the RNA polymerase from the transcribed in the operon. See, this is about the absence of inducer. But in case of in presence of inducer, see here the it is a one of the process. It depends on only the inducer. So here in presence of inducer, what happened? See the same diagram. We also it is a promoter, it is an inhibitory gene and operator and ZYA. These all are the structural genes. See here, in absence of inducer, see here the repressor binds to the operator region and prevents RNA polymerase from the transplant in the operon. But here what happened? Here the repressor mRNA. See, this is the inducer. See what happened here? Means in presence of inducer such as lactose or allolactose, means here the repressor mRNA means the repressor inactivated by interaction with the inducer. See, this is the inducer and this is the repressor mRNA. The repressor mRNA inactivated by the interaction with the inducer. So already it is inactivated by the interaction of the inducer. So this condition which is helps to allows the RNA polymerase. So here it helps to allows the RNA polymerase in the region of operon. So it helps to formation of the three enzymes, those are the beta galactosidase, permease and transacetylase. So it helps to means it assists to the promoter and means it helps to forms the transcription process. So here the one thing which is a very important, in absence of inducer the repressor binds to the operator region and prevent the RNA polymerase. So here RNA polymerase only helps the formation of the sum of the enzymes. So here what happens in the absence of inducer, the repressor mRNA, that's the messenger RNA, the repressor RNA binds to the operator region and prevents the RNA polymerase, and there is no any formation of the enzyme and there is no any kind of the transcription. But in case of presence of inducer, the repressor mRNA inactivated by the interaction with the inducer. So this is the inducer. So here the repressor RNA inactivated by interaction with the inducer. So it means in this condition it helps to allows the RNA polymerase. So this RNA polymerase assists to the promoters and this helps to proceed the transcription. So this is the transcription and here the sum of the enzyme. See, the Z it codes for the beta galactosidase and Y it codes for the permease and A it codes for the transacetylase. See, it is a very important for your examination. That is the lab operon concept. Okay, see, one is in absence of inducer and the second one in presence of inducer. Okay, see, main points here. In absence of inducer, the repressor binds to the operator region and prevents the RNA polymerase. But in the presence of inducer, here the repressor which is activated means inactivated by the interaction with the inducer and allows the RNA polymerase in the region of operon. So it helps to formation of, it helps to assist to the So the inducer, it inactivates the repressor and allows the